Today, we're diving into a topic that's relevant for both employees and employers. Philippine labor laws on bonuses, allowances, benefits, and deductions. And here's the good news. We'll go through everything in a way that's easy to understand, and I'll be sharing the latest details for 2024, including de minimis benefits and their total threshold for the year. So hey everyone, Dennis Hilario here. I'm an entrepreneur, consultant, and someone who's passionate about simplifying business for all of you. Whether you're a first-time visitor or a loyal subscriber, welcome. But before we get started, do me a favor. If you find this content valuable, make sure to subscribe, like this video, and hit that notification bell so you're always in the loop for content that will help you in your business journey. So let's dive in. So let's kick things off with bonuses. If there's one bonus that gets everyone excited, it's the 13th month pay. So in the Philippines, it's mandatory, meaning if you are a rank and file employee who's worked for at least a month, you're entitled to receive the 13th month pay. So this bonus is essentially 1/12 of your basic salary for the calendar year. And just so you know, it must be paid before December 24th. Is that every bit of cash everyone looks forward to around the holidays. However, when we talk about other bonuses like performance-based incentives, Christmas bonuses, or any other special bonus your company might offer, those are discretionary. Employers are not required by law to give them unless they're specifically mentioned in your employment contract or a collective bargaining agreement or a company policy. So let's move on to allowances. Now, one type of allowance that's particularly important in the Philippines is the cost of living allowance, or COLA. It is non-taxable. So think of COLA as your employer's way of saying, I know it costs more to live these days, so here's a little something to help. It meant to cover the rising cost of living, and though it's not part of the basic wage, it does play a role in calculating your benefits like overtime pay, night shift premiums, and yes, even your 13th month pay. So COLA is region specific. The amount varies depending on where you are in the country. So beyond COLA, there are other allowances like transportation, meal, and representation allowances. Many of these are non-taxable up to a specific limit, but if they go over that threshold, they are considered part of your taxable income. We'll discuss that later under de minimis benefits. So, COLA is determined by the Regional Tripartite Wages and Productivity Board, and the rates vary again by region. So, therefore, the COLA amount is not uniform across the entire country. So COLA is generally not considered part of the basic salary. However, it is included in the computation of other wage-related benefits. COLA can be paid daily or monthly depending on the local wage orders. It is typically granted to daily wage workers and may be adjusted periodically by the board according to the economic conditions and cost of living changes. The exact amount of COLA is based on, again, the regional wage orders and can range from around 10 pesos to over 90 pesos per day, depending on the economic conditions and prevailing minimum wage of the region. To find the specific COLA rate applicable to a particular region and sector like non-agriculture, agriculture, retail, or service, you must refer to the latest wage order issued by the board in that region. For example, in Metro Manila, as per the latest wage order updates, the COLA can be 20 to 30 pesos per day on top of the daily minimum wage. Again, in other regions, it may vary and could be lower or higher depending on the factors like inflation, standard of living, and local economic conditions. You can visit the official website of the Department of Labor and Employment or the National Wages and Productivity Commission as they provide updates on the latest wage orders. Now, let's talk about a topic that's often misunderstood, the de minimis benefits. If you're not familiar with the term, these are essentially small perks or allowances your employer can give you that are non-taxable. And for 2024, there are updated thresholds you need to know, as well as the total combined threshold for the year. So let's break it down. Let's break down the de minimis benefits and their limits for 2024. First is RICE subsidy. So it's up to 2,000 pesos per month or 24,000 pesos per year. Uniform and clothing allowances. So up to 6,000 pesos per year. Medical cash allowance for dependents is up to 1,500 pesos per year. Laundry allowance up to 300 pesos per month or 3,600 pesos per year. Achievement awards. These are tangible personal property like a plaque or a watch, for example. It's not exceeding 10,000 pesos per year. And lastly, the daily meal allowance for overtime work or night shifts, not exceeding 25% of the basic minimum wage in your region. So the total threshold for all de minimis benefits combined is 90,000 pesos per year. If your de minimis benefits do not exceed this amount, they remain non-taxable. However, any amount beyond this limit will be subject to income tax. So it is really a great way for employers to reward their employees without additional tax implications. And for employees, it means more value in your pocket. Alright, so next benefit benefits that I'd like to discuss are the government mandated benefits. So these include contributions to SSS, PhilHealth, and Pag-ibig. So as you know, employers and employees both contribute to these funds. SSS provides financial security for sickness, maternity, and retirement, while PhilHealth ensures access to healthcare. And Pag-ibig helps employees with savings and housing loans. So these deductions are mandatory and are based on the salary bracket. So the great thing about these contributions is they serve as a financial safety net covering you for those important life events like healthcare or when you eventually retire. You also have leave benefits as discussed in the past video, such as the Service Incentive Leave or SIL, which entitles employees with at least 1 year of service to 5 days of paid leave annually. Plus, there are other leave policies like maternity, paternity, solo parent leave, and others, ensuring that employees have the support they need throughout their employment journey. So the deductions are the amount taken out of the employee's salary before they receive the take-home pay. Again, this include the required contributions to SSS, PhilHealth, and Pag-ibig, and of course, the withholding tax compensation if applicable. However, your employer can't just deduct anything they want. They must follow specific legal guidelines. So, for example, if the employee owes the company money or are liable for certain damages, the deduction must be fair and require the employee's consent. The labor code is designed to protect employees from unauthorized or unreasonable deductions. One more thing, let's not forget the no work, no pay policy. This rule means that if the employee is absent without leave credits, the employee does not get paid for those days. However, if the employee has earned leave credits, they are entitled to pay time off. And there you have it, Philippine labor laws made simple. We've covered bonuses, allowances, benefits, deductions, de minimis perks, along with their updated limits for 2024. So whether you are an employee trying to understand your pay or an employer making sure you're compliant, knowing these laws makes a huge difference. So if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share with your colleagues or friends, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for for more insights on business and labor laws. And as always, keep learning, keep growing, and keep taking those small steps toward a better working environment for everyone. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. TX Your Life and Business. Have a great day.